Hey, welcome to Building an Outdoor Wood Fire Oven Hearth with me, Angel. I haven't done this very much. I did it one other time, in fact, so this is my second one of these, and of course, it's totally different from the first one, so I'm just making it up as I go along. I do have a background in ceramics and some other stonework, so these are old tire, earth-filled tires, remnants of a wall that was going to be this Head Hutt structure originally, but it ended up getting moved over there. So I'm going to go ahead and use these as my base. I have this built up here already with some stones. They've been settling already for a couple of years, so I know they're well settled. On top of that, I've made basically a little scoop, a little bowl with some stones. I'm going to put a few more over there, although I could fill that in with my hearth mix. And then I've put some insulative mix. So this is pumice stone. It's a real light rock that floats in water. It's highly insulative. And I just happen to have some mixed in with some sand. So that just went, I just had buckets of that left over from another project. So I dumped that in this bowl. And now I'm going to mix up a mixture. I've reviewed several recipes and decided in typical fashion to make up my own recipe. So I will let you know how it goes in the future, but how my plan is to take the wheelbarrow, the shovel, and mix up, I think I'm going to go six or seven parts perlite, which I just happen to have bought in bags. It's kind of like extra light pumice, basically, like extra heated. And it's, again, highly insulative. I'm going to do six parts of that by volume to one part Portland cement, which I have over here on these tarps, one part hydrated lime powder, which I also have under here, and one part fire clay. That's kind of a weird mixture between a refractory cement. You would mix lime, Portland, and fire clay, or maybe not the lime at all, if you had time to let it cure, and sand, like nine parts sand to three parts or even more, two to nine or three to nine. Of dry powder, and that's your lime and fire clay and possibly Portland. That's going to give you a good basic refractory mix, which is going to bounce the heat back in the inside of your oven. So you want to use that for mortar and on the very inside if you're not using bricks or between bricks. And then for the insulative layer, you want to use more insulation, which a ceramic blanket is a good underlay. And then this pumice makes a really great mix with again, I'm gonna risk using Portland, which may very well crack more than other mixes, but I'm gonna put in a lot of lime and fire clay and hope for the best, and I'll let you know how it goes. I'm gonna try to pause this video, get some mixing underway, and come back and show you, but just in case I lose you, stay tuned and on the lookout for other videos. So while I'm getting my stuff together, I thought of a couple things I wanted to remind you. One is make sure and wear rubber gloves, chemical resistant, the blue kind or the black kind for mixing up anything with lime or concrete in it, because it will burn your skin. And also need a dust mask if you're working with lime or concrete dust, in particular clay dust too. It's a good idea to wear a dust mask. I may or may not find one of those, and if I don't, I'm going to get a bandana to at least put over my face for the dusty part till I get stuff wetted. So I've got my wheelbarrow and I wetted it a little bit. I've got some water on hand, I've got a measuring bucket, I've got my perlite, and I'm going to go get my gloves and my mask on and open up my Portland cement and my fire clay and my lime, and I'll be back. All right, I couldn't find a mask, so I got a tie-dye dish towel. It's clean, relatively. Bandana works good, too. Just something to at least attempt to keep the dust. This actually works probably better than a bandana. And I've got my rubber gloves, and I've got a knife to slice open my Portland cement and my lime, and I've got an already open bag over there. I've got my perlite. I'm gonna put it all in this wheelbarrow, and then I'll be back and let you watch me mix a little bit. All right, I'm gonna let you watch me measure so you can see how loose my measurements are, and so I can document for myself, so in case I forget, because kind of like baking a cake, I tend to kind of go by eye and ear and stuff, so I got all my ingredients out, and so this is my measuring bucket, but I just washed it out, and now it's wet, and I don't really want stuff to stick in it, but I guess for demonstration purposes, what the heck. Oh, that's a perfect demonstration, so you can see kind of messy stuff. It's windy out. I'm going to put this on better and get approximately 6 of these to start. That was about 1.5. I'm going to just count the spill as 1 and do 5, right? So that's 2, whoop, 3, 4, and 5. Plus there was at least one spill. I was going to dump this whole partial bag in, but that looks like probably enough. I don't want to make too much more than I need today. I'm going to close this so that dust doesn't go in there. All right. Now I've got some fire clay. This is hawthorn clay. I got it at the clay store. High fire clay. It's more of a refractory thing, but I'm going to use it. You can see it's pretty dusty. Glad I got my mask. Oh, I should mention, you want to mix up your dry. You want to wet your wheelbarrow so things don't stick. And then you want to mix all your dry in with that perlite. Coat all the perlite and then add your water. And add less water than you think you need. But then again, perlite soaks up water. It's kind of an interesting thing. So anyway, I'm making up this recipe as I go. I forgot the sand, but it's right over there. I'm going to go one of these. That's high fire clay. I'm going to do one pot cement. That's this gray stuff here. Try not to... real fine powder. I'm going to do one lime powder. Also be careful. Lime is a super light powder and it will burn you. So not instantly, but in time for sure. You don't want to get that on you or breathe it in. This is silica sand, aka pool sand. It's a little different from builder sand or feldspar sand, which is probably fine for this balance as well, this mix. As I said, this is kind of an experimental mix of looking for my knife. This is an experimental mix, kind of a cross between a high fire and an insulated mix, or refractory rather. And I'm going to use it for an outdoor oven hearth, so that's why. Alright, I think I'm going to go a whole bag of sand, which if you were just doing pure insulation, you wouldn't do. Let me think this through. No, I guess I'm just doing about one scoop of sand, approximately. I'm going to mix that up and see how it looks. I'm going to put this on. Oh, let me show you just real quick. In the wheelbarrow. Oop, can you see that? So, it's about like half full of perlite and half full of all the other dry stuff. I'm going to mix it with my mask on and my gloves, even though I don't really need these yet. Luckily, the wind is working in our favor away from my sight. A lot of people use a hoe for this. I find a flat shovel works much more efficiently.
You want to get all the white covered evenly with all the other stuff. Most people, if you were using a hoe, you'd have to do a time lapse. But check it out. It's that fast and easy to do the dry part. It's nice and evenly mixed. So now I'm going to add some water. And I'm going to start with one or two parts. See how that looks and add some more if need be. Still working all by volume here with my little 1 gallon bucket. I have some water all ready to go. I'm gonna add two parts to start. And a mix. That might be too much. Let's see. Going to work from all the different edges and angles. Make sure you get it all mixed. It's a great core workout. Get your guts into it. It's looking pretty good. I got a couple little dry spots in. Alright, I'm going to show you what that looks like and then I'm going to modify a little bit just based on what it looks like because I'm wanting it to be a nice firm, though insulative, I want it to be a strong enough base to hold the weight over on my hearth there. So, see, that's pretty evenly mixed. But it's looking a little, a little super light. So what I'm going to do is add a little more sand and a little more Portland. Not a lot of Portland. Maybe a little, like just a smidge, Portland and a smidge, fire clay, and another scoop or so of the sand. And then maybe a little more water. We'll see how this goes. I suppose I could do the line too, keep it 1:1:1. So, start with adding a little more sand. Just about a skosh of the Portland. I don't want to get Portland in my fire clay, so I'm going to just pour a little skosh of that. Skosh of the lime. That's a skosh today, in case you're wondering. I didn't look it up. I might be totally wrong. I'm going to go just a little skosh of water, too, to rinse out my bucket. Mix that in. So now that I'm adding dry to already wet, it's just a little trickier to get it evenly mixed. So I want to make sure you spread it out. Get my amazing mixing power on. It's definitely easier to do it all the dry first, but what happens when you're making stuff up? You're going by eyeball. Sometimes sometimes you gotta adjust, right? I'm gonna go just to Nova Scotia water. Mix that around a little. Position so I can get my muscle into it. Another direction. Come around this way. Do some scooping and flipping. Baking concrete always reminds me of baking cakes or cookies. Kind of similar in a way. Bread. Any kind of chemistry like that. Kind of fun. Get the basics right, you usually do all right. We'll see. Gonna have to check back future videos to see how this mix holds up over time. But I will report, so if you're interested, do check back. I'm gonna call that a well-mixed hearth mix. This video is getting on in length too, so probably gonna call it good and then make a follow-up video for the actual laying of the hearth. But there you go, you can see it's a nice, pretty good consistency. And I'm gonna go scoop it over there into my area. And I'll let you know how it goes. Maybe I'll try pausing you, see if my camera will hold out battery-wise just for a little more so I can show you the finished hearth. If not, tune back for another video. I'm Angel. Give me a thumbs up. Feel free to ask me some questions. Just in case I forgot to show in this same video, I know I made another video about my underlay on this big base. That's my pumice and sand. Getting ready to get covered up by 2 to 4 inches or so of this hearth mix that I just made up. Finish dumping it on here, smooth it out, see if my camera will still work. You can check out the description for more info if you're interested. So I'm still racing the camera here, but I just wanted to show you. I figure I'm going to do a 23-inch dome, and I need at least 4 inches of brick and insulation. It's probably more like 6 to 8, but I can work around that. Let me think this through, but I need at least... Yeah, I need at least 31 to set my bricks on and then come over that with the insulation. So as you can see, I've got my mix down, but I don't have 31 inches across that way. I do have it about this long way. I don't quite have it leveled out. So I'm going to keep working to get that out to as close as I can to the 31 inches and level. And if the camera... cooperates, I will see you another time. All right, I want to remind you real quick before I forget to make sure and clean out your wheelbarrow and shovel before you get on to any finish work. That way you'll just save yourself a lot of agony later. I like to use they sell brushes for them or a rag, and a dust broom works. That's what I just used. But you don't want to just spray it down. You want to get that film off, and you want to do it sooner than later. Take care of your shovel and your wheelbarrow. Trust me, you will be glad you did later. I'm going to leave this rolling. So I have checked for, it's pretty level, and it's 31 across. It's not quite as round as I'd like it to be, so I'm going to do a little more finishing. I don't have my good trowel. I've got this weird tile one, so I'm going to use just that edge. But the cool thing is I don't mind a little texture, and I don't mind a little off level because I'm going to level it off with sand after it cures, and then use my fire bricks for the rest of my hearth before I build up the dome. So that does it. Well, I'm going to set you down and say, maybe the camera will last, maybe it won't till I finish, but don't forget to look in the description for ways you can connect with me and support me if you're interested in knowing more about my projects. I got some books out there, I got some projects going I need help with, and till next time, I wish you love, lightheartedness, creativity, and don't forget to play every day. Playfulness in everything else you do, it gets a lot better. A lot like frosting a cake, see? Concrete just splinters from my cooking. I know we should have just a little more mix. That's all right. Let's squish this down a little bit more. You don't want to overwork the top of your concrete. You don't want to underwork it either. It's a perfect amount. You don't want to settle it, get all the air bubbles down there. It also, I mean, depending on what's your finish layer, then you do want to work it good. In this case, I don't mind a little texture. Like I mentioned, I'm going to actually put a little layer of sand to even it out before I put my fire bricks down on top of it. So it doesn't matter that much what it looks like, but I want it to be strong, so it could be meshing it together, get all those particles to gel into one solid mass. Line up. Get situated together. I can count a little off level, but I'm going to do another check and see how far. A little over the edge there. Is it?